friend who is study history, be seriously, okay, ancient history it is, and now today our topics, post-Mauryan invaders, the Indo-Greeks, okay. A number of invasions took place around 200 BC. The first to invade India were the Greeks, who were also called the Indo-Greeks or Bactrian Greeks, okay. The most famous Indo-Greeks ruler reach was Mirander, okay. 160 BC to 145 BC, also known as Milind, okay. He had, also known as Milind. He had his capital at Sankala, modern Sialkot in Punjab. He was converted to Buddhism by Nagasena and Nagarjuna, described in Milindapanho, or the question of Milinda. Okay, the Greeks were the first to issue gold coins to in India. The Sakas or Scythians, okay, now we discuss. The Greeks were followed by the Sakas, who controlled a larger part of India than the Greeks did. Okay, there were five branches of the Sakas with their seats of power in different parts of the India and Afghanistan. A king of Ujjain, who called himself Vikramaditya, okay, defeated Sakas in 58 BC and started Vikrama Sambhat. Okay, the most famous Saka ruler in India was Rudradhaman, okay, 130 AD to 150, okay. He is famous for the repairs of Sudrasana, okay, Sudrasana lake in Kathiawar. His inscription was the Junagarh inscription. The most famous Saka ruler in India, Rudradhaman. Please remember Rudradhaman, important. Okay, there were five branches of Sakas. Their seats of power, different parts in India and Afghanistan. Okay, a king of Ujjain, also called Vikramaditya, okay, defeated Sakas, 58 BC, Vikramaditya defeated. Okay, this is famous, the repairs of Sudrasana, lack of Kathiawar. His inscription was the Junagarh inscription. Okay,